Good evening, everyone. My name is Aastha, and I'm the USA Canada counselor at Advice International. Today, I'm going to speak about a very important topic, which is ticket to study corporate and business law abroad. Now, but before I begin, I would like to inform you that I'm going to have a question answer session in the end. So if you have any questions, you can ask me in the end of the session. Now, corporate law, also known as business law or enterprise law, is the body of law governing the rights, relations, and conducts of persons, companies, organizations, and businesses. Whilst the term company or business law is used interchangeably with corporate law, business law often refers to wider concepts of commercial law. That is the law relating to commercial or business related activities. In some cases, this may include matters relating to corporate governance or financial law. When used as a substitute for corporate law, business law means the law relating to the business corporations. It is one of the most popular law specializations that is opted by candidates these days. Thus, in simple words, corporate law deals with forming, owning, operating, and managing of a corporation. A corporate lawyer can work in a large or mid-sized firm. They usually counsel clients and also handles business transactions, which include negotiation, drafting, as well as a review of contracts and other agreements that are associated with the activities of the company business, like mergers, acquisitions, divestments, etc. Now, you can pursue undergraduate as well as the postgraduate level programs in the field of corporate law. In UG level courses, candidates need to pursue integrated law courses, wherein after completing a basic graduation degree, one can specialize in corporate law. On the other hand, in a PG level law course, aspirants can straight away specialize in corporate law. Some popular PG level courses in corporate law are LLM in corporate law, LLM in business corporate law, LLM in corporate and banking law, etc. Now, I'll talk about the eligibility criteria. The eligibility criteria for a corporate law course may vary from college to college. Candidates who want to apply for a 5-year integrated course with corporate law as a specialization meet the eligibility criteria for the course if they have completed the class 12. Now, the eligibility criteria for corporate law course offered at the PG level is such that candidates should have completed a 5-year integrated law course or possesses an LLB or equivalent degree. Now, different courses available in law is company law, criminal justice, forensic law, international commercial arbitration, international criminal law, etc. Now, I'm going to talk about law courses in some of the countries, starting with UK first. UK degree courses are designed to develop your skills in critical thinking, reasoned argument and problem solving, qualities that appeal to employers all over the world. There are three legal systems in the UK, one for England and Wales, one for Northern Ireland and another for Scotland. Though elements such as commercial law and taxation law are similar, to qualify as a lawyer in the UK, you need to complete modules in seven areas known as the foundations of legal knowledge, including subjects such as public, criminal and property law. Once completed, you will be awarded an LLB or BA honours in law. You can then progress straight to the legal practice courses, also known as LPC, or the bar professional training courses known as BPTC, to qualify as a barrister. Now, at postgraduate level, taught law master's program are usually studied full-time over 1 year and lead to a Master of Laws, which is LLM, or Masters of Arts qualification. If you have an undergraduate degree in a subject other than law, you can take a conversion course to join the legal sector. The Common Professional Exam CPE and Graduate Diploma in Law GDL gives the training required to work as a solicitor or barrister in England and Wales. Now I'm going to quickly talk about the entry requirements for UK. Now, undergraduate law, for international students wishing to study law at undergraduate level, an IELTS score of no less than 6 across all 4 categories with an overall 7 score is required, with a percentage of at least 60 to 65%. Now, top universities will ask for LNAT score It is used for universities to help them select people for their undergraduate law courses. PG entry requirements, universities require 60% at the UG level and IELTS of 7 with no bands less than 6.5 in each band. Universities require for tier 2 universities at the UG level an IELTS score of 6.5. Now tuition fee of 1 year LLB is the range of 10,000 GBP to 15,000 GBP, and the tuition fee for LLM program mostly is in the range of 12,000 to 16,000 GBP with major universities. Now I'm going if we talk about where you can study law in UK, some of the universities are Queen Mary University, King's College London, University of York, Queen University, Belfast, University of Nottingham, Cardiff. Next, I'm going to talk about law courses in US, starting with degrees. Now, universities in US do not typically offer a bachelor's of law. Instead, US law students will learn a bachelor of science in law as an entry-level degree program. Studying to earn a bachelor degree in law allows students to prepare for their future careers and education. Now, BA in legal studies is also one of the options in US. In the United States, a law school is an institution where students obtain a professional education in law after first obtaining an undergraduate degree. Law schools in the US issue the JD, which is Juris Doctor degree, which is a professional doctorate and for most practitioners a terminal degree. Other degrees included the Masters of Law. Most law schools are colleges, schools or other units within a larger post-secondary institution such as a university. Legal education is very different in the United States from that in many other parts of the world where students obtain a professional education in law after first obtaining an undergraduate degree. Now, coming to the entry requirements, for the JD course, student needs to take LSAT exam along with IELTS or TOEFL. If you're planning to take IELTS, it should be 6.5 overall, 6 in each band. If you're planning to take TOEFL, it should be 80 out of 120. Now for LLM students, needs to have a percentage of 60%. In LLB degree along with TOEFL score of 80 or above or IELTS of 6.5 overall. Now, LSAT examination is required by very few universities. If we talk about the tuition cost, it can vary between $25,000 to $80,000, which is approximately 20 lakhs to 50 lakhs. Some of the popular states in US for law programs are Washington, New York, Los Angeles, San Francisco, Boston, and Chicago. And some of the top universities in USA are Harvard, Columbia, University of Illinois Chicago, Yale, Stanford, University of Pennsylvania, and New York University. To practice law, the student needs to give a bar exam. In USA, they initially have to start as an executive and go to being a partner in a law firm. Average salary can start from 1 lakh USD dollar a year. Now, in conclusion, regardless of the type of program you go with, studying law abroad requires attention to a more particular set of requirements than for any other course. Now, whether your interest lies in commercial law or criminal justice, you will need to be sure that your destination is relevant to your long-term goals and interests. Also, I would like to inform you that at Advice, we are conducting International Corporate and Business Law Virtual Fair tomorrow on Zoom. It's going to be between 3 to 6 p.m. You can register yourself on our website or on our Facebook page or Instagram page for the fair tomorrow. Now, so if you have any questions, you can ask me now. Does anyone have any questions? Any questions, guys? If you have any questions regarding any other course, you can ask me if it is related to US and Canada. And if it is related to any other country, let me know that we are having virtual counseling sessions every day. So you can book your slot on our website, which is www.adviseinternational.com. Now someone is asking me sports management at Humber College. Yes, what about it? So if you're planning for some advanced diploma course, the percentage should be 60% and you might have to take an IELTS of 6.5 overall, 6 in each band. Shehbaz, are you talking about UK or any other country? Bhanu Prakash, you're telling me I'm interested in business management. May I know you're planning for which country? So if you're looking for any other country apart from US and Canada, I would like you to at least give your email ID so that we can get back to you. The concerned counselor will give you a call back or he or she will email you. So Shehbaz, if you're planning for US, you should have a LLB degree with minimum 60% and with a TOEFL score of 80 or above and an IELTS score of 6.5 overall, 6 in each band. Now if we talk about Canada, Canada does not usually offer LLM or any course like that. They have paralegal course, so you can plan for that. any other questions? Job opportunities after doing sports management, which one is better, Canada or Europe? Both the countries are fine. If you want to speak to one of our UK counselor or European counselor, you can just connect with us on our website and you can have a one-on-one session with the counselor. She will tell you what all options you have for sports management. It totally depends what is your ultimate aim, whether you want to settle down or you want to come back, or are you looking at the course curriculum or anything of sort of that. Can you just tell me which country is best to do PG diploma programs, ma'am? You have an option of Canada. They have PG diploma courses. Apart from that, you can definitely check with other countries. If you want a proper counseling, you can, as I said, you can connect with us on our website. And you can ask for a virtual session with us. Now, which country is best for the course for journalism? Vanshika, it depends on your budget and what type of course you're looking for, if it's bachelor's or master's, and basically what budget are you looking for. Will it be good to be there in this year? Are you talking about, may I know you're talking about which country? United Kingdom for LLM. Yes, definitely you can plan for it. No worries. Doesn't need to change anything due to COVID. No, nothing much. But you can still speak to one of the counselors at Advice who can help you with the UK process. How much bands required to get admission in masters in UK for business field? 6.5 overall, 6 in each band. in Canada. Are you asking me 12 years of gap accepted in UK or Canada? Which country are you talking about? I'm not sure because I don't look after UK, but as I said, if you want, we can connect you with one of the UK counselors. Which is the best in terms of living conditions and lifestyle overall, UK or Australia or Netherlands or Canada or Singapore? Oh, you have so many options. Well, see, it totally depends again how much budget do you have. Now, Canada is one of the friendliest country, so you can plan for that country. And apart from that, if you ask me, US is also another good country. But if you want to know about other countries, as I said, I only look after US and Canada. So if you want to speak to any of the other country counselor, you can, as I said, connect with us on our website and you can have a proper counseling session with us. Also register for our tomorrow's fair, which is going to be for law students. A lot of UK universities are going to be there and a few universities from Ireland and US. You can register yourself on our website and you can just meet the universities and clear your doubts with them directly. And if I have missed any questions, you can just direct message us and we'll get back to you. I know that SAT have become optional this year for US universities, but has every university made that optional? Not really. Not all the universities have made it optional. You will have to check the university website and just see if they have waived it off or not. Any other questions? Do I need a renewed passport to apply to Canadian universities? Yes, definitely. Any other question, guys? Okay, I can see no more questions. So guys, if I've missed any questions, you can just direct message us and we'll get back to you. Also, as I said, we'll be having a fair tomorrow. It's gonna be between 3 to 6 p.m. You can register yourself for that and you can directly speak to the universities. Thank you so much.